Well, I wondered what this guy was going to say after all the news coming out that Mr. Biden is supposedly the next president of the United States. We're going to get into the comments from Mr. Bush. Before I go any further, guys, if you enjoy the daily content I provide for you here on YouTube, I encourage you could help support the channel over on Patreon for as little as $5 a month. Patreon.com/conservativetruth. That link in the description gets you access to over 25 exclusive podcasts where I talk more about sensitive information. Plus, you get the alerts for anything that goes out onto Patreon, unlike YouTube, where you won't be notified of all the videos that I put out, even if you have that bell selected, because YouTube doesn't like me. But I know you guys do like me, so when you get done watching me here, browse back and check what you've missed. Please like this video, share it, hit the bell, subscribe, and I wear the glasses because I'm blind. So, George Bush, former President George W. Bush, releasing a statement on the new president-elect, I have that in quotation marks, Biden, saying that Joe Biden is a good man. He's happy for Joe. He believes that Joe is going to help to heal and unify. He also said that President Trump has every right to be able to challenge this in courts for recounts, everything like that. But after he said that, he went on to say that the American people can have confidence that the election was fundamentally fair and that the outcome is clear. No, it's not. The outcome is not clear. Mr. Bush, you would think that somebody was in a similar situation like this back in 2000 could maybe relate a little bit to what Trump is currently dealing with right now. And why would Bush come out and just give Biden this support, this congratulations, when this thing isn't over yet? It's not over. I don't think Bush liked it, very much. You know, he wouldn't have liked it if people were running around and declaring that he was the loser, everything like that. And he went through something similar. I mean, I think, honestly, this is much worse than what he went through with the whole recount thing in Florida with Al Gore. This is much worse than that. But we know that Bush is not a real true Republican. This is a neocon, just like his father, okay, everybody else. Bush should have waited until all of the litigation was over with, all the legal battles, all the votes were recounted, and then, and only if then, it still came out that Biden was the winner, well then, fine. Congratulate him, wish him the best, call him a unifier. I mean, he's not, he never will be. But then that's your time to do that. But to do this now as a former president, congratulating him and saying how proud you are and that the outcome is clear, the outcome is not clear. It is not clear. Don't listen to these people. Also, Republicans coming out and congratulating Biden way too early. Lisa Murkowski, Alaska, not a surprise with her. She's another fake Republican. And Mitt Romney congratulating his good friend Joe Biden as well. We know Romney didn't even vote for Trump. Okay, he voted for Amy Coney Barrett to get on the Supreme Court. At least he did that. She's going to probably play a huge factor in this once we get to that point, ladies and gentlemen. I know that she is. So I'm disappointed in President Bush, but I'm not surprised either because he has a history of doing this. We know that the whole Bush family was all in on it. They're friends with the Clintons, okay? They were, Bush, and I think he voted for Hillary, back in 2016. And for all those that are celebrating right now Biden's so-called victory across this nation, they're so happy right now, guys. I talked about this on another video, and if you missed it, I'm going to say it again for you right now. When the truth is revealed, all of this is uncovered, and Trump is actually named the true winner of this election, you are going to see a meltdown in this country, the likes of something you've never seen before in your life. Before, the liberals started crying right away because Trump was declared the winner basically on election night. And they started crying immediately. But now they're celebrating, but it's a little bit premature. So imagine the meltdown when their winner is taken away from them, legally, mind you, because it's going to be proven in the courts that there was fraud, that Biden really did not win this thing. They are going to lose their minds a million times worse than what they did in 2016. Be prepared for it. I'm telling you right now to be prepared for it. You can come back to this video. You can watch it then. And you'll see that I was right on the money with this. I don't know when this is going to happen. Obviously within the next 2 months before inauguration happens in January. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section. What do you think about Bush's comments saying the outcome is clear and everything, the nonsense that he's spewing? Thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I'll be back with more. You guys take care. Please be safe out there. God bless each and every single one of you. And I'll talk with you soon.